So why do children get type 1 diabetes? Researchers have been trying to answer this question for decades, and we still don't clearly understand what causes the disease.
Hi, my name is Ruth. I'm the mum of three children. Faith, age 10, Ethan, age 8, and Joshua, age 5. When Faith was 20 months, she was diagnosed with type 1 diabetes. Ethan was diagnosed at age 4. Joshua, he doesn't have type 1 diabetes. It was a big shock to have two children with type 1. There isn't any history in our family of type 1 diabetes, either on my side or my husband's. It's just one of those things that's happened. Times quite hard, especially when you go through situations where you do blame yourself a lot. When they first are diagnosed, you wonder what the reasons are, why, what did I do wrong, could I have helped this in any form, but there isn't any answer, and they do say it's nothing that we could have done to prevent it.
It's not just about genes, that much we do know. What I'd say to the parents is that even if they were to pass on the genetic risk of the disease, it's not a foregone conclusion that their child will get the disease.
Right, time to do a test, guys, okay?
There's a lot of research going into trying to understand what causes childhood type 1 diabetes and how best to prevent the disease. Here at the Telethon Kids Institute, we have a dedicated diabetes research team researching a variety of different angles of how we can understand this disease better to improve the chances of children not developing the disease in the future.
Okay, what's your level, Ethan?
10.3.
So it's 10.3. Okay, great.
Mothers, fathers, and babies can all be screened to see if they have the high-risk genes of the disease. However, even if they are found to have high-risk genes for type 1 diabetes, this does not necessarily mean that they will develop the disease.
With Faith, the doctors did say that when she was diagnosed with type 1, that it could be related to the autoimmunity involved with the Down syndrome. For Josh, he hasn't been tested. There's no point in getting hung up on what the could-bes. I think that, you know, the best thing to do is to live life to the full and enjoy it, and then obviously if it happens, you deal with it.
If your father has type 1 diabetes, the risk of the child having type 1 diabetes is actually higher than if it's the child's mother that has type 1 diabetes, but we don't know why that's the case. As we don't understand what causes type 1 diabetes yet, there isn't anything that can be done to reduce the risk of a child from developing type 1 diabetes.
Hopes for our research is obviously for a cure, but mainly as well is just helping them to live a normal life. There's nothing you can do about it, you just get on with life, live it to the full, and with the added technology of today and the advances of research, it makes our lives easier day by day. Yeah. They love life, it doesn't stop them, they do everything their friends do. Sleepovers, out playing games. Pumps are fantastic, technology is fantastic, and it can be managed.